Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to discuss about molecular orbital energy diagram. So it is simple HOMO diatomic molecules like nitrogen and oxygen. Before that, there are few rules based on which the electron can fill in the molecular orbitals. And everyone knows that when atomic orbitals are overlapping, it results in different types of molecular orbitals, which are bonding and antibonding. The bonding molecular orbitals will have lower energy than antibonding molecular orbitals. So generally, the molecular orbitals are arranged in the increasing order of their energy. For suppose, a molecular orbital is produced from by the combination of 1s atomic orbitals, then the resultant molecular orbitals will have least energy. As their respective atomic orbitals have least energy, they will also have least energy. So the order will start with the sigma 1s orbital, and then its respective antibonding molecular orbital, which can be represented as sigma star 1s, and next level will be sigma 2s, and then sigma star 2s. So based on which atomic orbitals are overlapping and it results in the molecular orbitals, based on that the energy will be depends for the molecular orbitals, and all the molecular orbitals will be arranged in the increasing order of their energies. And now filling of the electrons. Generally, the each molecular orbital can accommodate a pair of electrons, same as atomic orbitals, and with the opposite spins. In case of pi 2px and pi 2py molecular orbitals, which are produced from 2p overlapping of 2p atomic orbitals, they will be still degenerated atomic molecular orbitals. So hence, when we are filling the electrons in such type of degenerated molecular orbitals, we should remember that they should be first partially half filled. Means partially filled, that is what each electron should be, one electron should be entered into each degenerated orbital, and then only the pairing will take place. These rules we must remember, and then we can move on to the how we can draw the MO diagram for oxygen and then the nitrogen. So here there is some variation from oxygen to the nitrogen, and if you can observe the sequence of the energy levels for different types of molecular orbitals, it is this sequence whatever I represented is a general sequence we can apply for any type of molecules, and where you can observe the sigma 1s will have least energy, and then this is in the order of increasing energy, so then sigma star 1s, then sigma 2s, sigma star 2s, sigma 2pz, pi 2py, pi 2px, or pi star 2px and pi star 2py, and then sigma star 2pz. This is a general sequence. But in case of smaller molecules, which from boron to nitrogen, the sequence will be different from the oxygen sequence or a regular sequence, because they have a lower effective nuclear charge, and because of the lower effective nuclear charge, there will be some repulsion between this 2s and this 2pz. Because of that repulsion, the 2pz orbital's energy will be raised, and so that the sequence will be different from the oxygen sequence. You can observe here this 2s after sigma star 2s, in case of oxygen it is sigma 2pz. But in case of nitrogen, there is a repulsion force between this 2s and 2pz. So the 2pz become its position varies after the pi orbitals. This is a basic difference between the oxygen and neon. Even in for a short answer question, this question can be asked that what is the basic difference in the molecular energy level sequence for oxygen and nitrogen and why? It's because of lower effective nuclear charge for nitrogen. And let's discuss the oxygen. The oxygen atomic number is 8, and individual oxygen atom, if you consider its electronic configuration, is 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. For a molecule O2, the sequence of the molecular orbitals can be given as sigma 1s2, sigma star 1s2, sigma 2s2, sigma star 2s2, sigma 2px2. You should remember one thing, that how many electrons are there in individual atom? 8 electrons in each atom, so overall 16 electrons. According to that only you have to write this 2-2 number. The sequence is as whatever we discussed in the previous slide. That's what the sequence. Then filling should start from this. 2 here, 4, hence 2, 2 plus 2, 4, plus 2, 6, plus 2, 8, and then 8 more electrons. So as I told in the previous few minutes back, that each molecular orbital can accommodate 2 electrons max. So here also 2, you can add 10, and then 6 more. So 2. And in case of these degenerated orbitals, I told you one electron should be enter first here and then enter into this pi orbital, and then only it can pair up. So as we have 16 electron, even pi orbitals 2-2, and then as I told the pi star, you can observe here one electron is entered into each pi star 2px and pi star 2py orbital. And if you can count, here the distinguishing is clear, that star, the molecular orbital which is represented with the star symbol are antibonding, and which are represented simply as sigma or pi, they are called as bonding. And here we need to calculate its bond order. Bond order formula is half of its number of bonding electrons minus antibonding electrons. And bond order indicates us how many number of bonds can exist in that molecule. And even we can estimate its bond strength also. More the bond number, its strength will be more. And in case of oxygen, the bonding electrons are 8. I'm taking the valency electrons, so 8 antibonding electrons are 4. And if you calculate it with half of NB minus NA, it gives us 2. Bond order 2 means 2 oxygen atoms combined with 2 bonds to form an oxygen molecule, means double bond. If you can check now, there are 2 unpaired electrons. As in the oxygen molecule, 2 unpaired electrons are there in the pi star antibonding molecular orbital. It is considered as a paramagnetic. Let's take a look of the diagram. Here in this image, I just ignored the 1s, but below this, the energy level should start with the 1s, and below 2s, there will be 1s also. Similarly, you'll get this sigma 1s and sigma star 1s. I just ignored that, and I represented with the 2s. And this 2s, 2s combine and results in sigma star, sigma 2s and sigma star 2s. And then from 2p, as this is 3 and 3, we will get 6 molecular orbitals. One is sigma 2pz, pi 2px, pi 2py, and their respective molecular orbitals. Now, let's consider nitrogen. As I told, the nitrogen will have a small variation in the sequence of molecular orbital's energy level due to lower effective nuclear charge. And if you calculate the bond order for this, it is 3. And if you can observe, there are no unpaired electrons, so hence nitrogen is considered as diamagnetic. And this is the sequence I represented here. Again, I ignored the 1s. Sigma 2s, I started with the sigma 2s and then sigma star 2s, and then the sequence changed here. First it comes pi 2px and pi 2py, then sigma 2pz, and then these two will remain as it is. And then when you are filling the electrons, there are 14 electrons. If you ignore 1s, like 4 electrons we should ignore, and then 10. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So there are no unpaired electrons, and hence it is considered as a diamagnetic. Thank you.